Well, well, what's up, YouTube? I'm Joker777, and it's been a good minute since I've done a little talk about movie news. Definitely wanted to try to get back to talking about that, and there's actually two stories that I wanted to cover today. First one is going to be your typical, like, this is like a movie news story that I've wanted to cover ever since I heard about it today, have some thoughts about it, and another one is just a feel-good type of story. So first up, we have the fact that the Batman director, who is going to be Matt Reeves, has dropped Ben Affleck's script. So apparently Matt Reeves is going to be going with his own script. He already has a plan in place. He has an idea of the story that he wants. And when I first heard this, it was kind of in the middle for me. And what I mean by that is, like, I think it's a good thing, but also could be a bad thing, specifically because when you look at Ben Affleck as a writer, he's written a lot of good things. Now, Matt Reeves himself has done a dang good job as far as writing, too. I think that he's proven his chops more as a director than he has more so of a writer. When you look at Ben Affleck, he's done Good Will Hunting, Gone Baby Gone, Live by Night, and now, or excuse me, I forgot one, my favorite, which is The Town. One of my favorite films that he's ever done. Probably my most favorite film that he's written, right up there with Good Will Hunting. So it kind of concerns me whenever I hear that they're dropping his script for another. Now again, Matt Reeves has written a few things, most notably War for the Planet of the Apes, which today is July 13th, 2017. War for the Planet of the Apes is coming out tomorrow, and I am very, very, very much excited about that. One of my most anticipated films of the year. But I don't know if I can really trust him to really take up the helm of writing, especially when Ben Affleck is such a good writer. And like I said, a lot of his movies that he's written, I actually really like. Another thing that I kind of want to talk about as far as this story goes is in Ben Affleck's script, the villain was supposed to be Deathstroke, and Joe Manganiello was actually cast, or however you say his name, I probably messed it all up, but he was slated to play Deathstroke, and it kind of worries me now. Now, I'm a little bit biased. I really, really like Deathstroke. I think he's a cool character. I think he could be an awesome villain that we haven't seen before. But will Matt Reeves actually use Deathstroke as the villain? I don't know. My only hope, and I don't know if this will come true or not, my only hope is that if you're going to use a new villain, can we please not use the Joker? Honestly, the Joker is one of my favorite villains of all time, but we have already seen the Joker so many times. I get that he's kind of like the archetype, the arch villain of Batman, I understand that, my favorite Batman villain by far, but it's the Joker has been done so many times by so many different people, and they would probably bring in Jared Leto, honestly, to play the Joker in the Batman film. But we've already had this. Why would we need to see it again? That's why I was kind of excited whenever I heard that Joe Manganiello was going to play Deathstroke, because it's a new villain. It's something new. Now, he is on Arrow, I understand that, but this would be like one of the first times we've ever seen him in a Batman film, at least a live-action one. Whereas with the Joker, he's been in, what, two live-action ones? Probably going to be a third one, because they probably are going to put him into the Ben Affleck storyline. Only time will tell. But that is my only hope, is that either they keep Deathstroke or they find someone that hasn't really been done yet. Maybe Killer Croc from Suicide Squad. I think that would be a cool villain to throw at Batman. We'll see. But that's just my thoughts on Ben Affleck not being used as a writer anymore. So now, let's turn to a story as my dog knocks down my controller, making a loud thud. I'm pretty sure that came through. That's nice. A story that really kind of touched me. This comes from Cinema Blend. apparently Mark Orsolo Jr., who has Down syndrome, lost his movie collection in a fire. Nearly all of his possessions went, but apparently he had like this big, giant movie collection. Movies were a big part of his life. He was an extremely big movie buff. After the fire, his sister Danielle actually went to social media and asked, could people actually help? Is there any way they could be willing to donate some movies to him? And boy, did they ever. Less than 24 hours after the initial post, says CinemaBlend, more than 300 movies were donated to help Mr. Orsolo rebuild his collection. Movies included a Rocky collection and more. It also looks like from the picture there's the Power Rangers, the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers seasons. This to me just really kind of touched me in a way. Because I myself am a movie buff. And to just think, like, if you lost your entire movie collection, like, that would actually kind of hurt. Because not only do I love movies, that's also a lot of money this kid spent building up this collection, and now it's gone. And that's just something that really kind of touched me in a way, to see people really rallying to give this man a movie collection back. 300 movies, that's a lot, too. Like, I don't own 300 movies. I think I have, like, a third of what this dude's got. But, again, that's just, it's a heartwarming story, and I kind of wanted to cover that. So, in the comments section down below, let me know what you thought of these two stories. Let me know what you thought about the fact that Matt Reeves will now be writing for the Batman rather than Ben Affleck. And, I guess let's spread some positivity. Let's talk about the story where Mark Orsolo gets his movie collection back thanks to the kindness of just amazing people in the world still today. With that being said, guys, I'm Joker777, and I'll see you guys later.